SolidWorks 2022 has given structural designers and manufacturers one of the greatest gifts this Christmas. With the new release comes a huge upgrade to SolidWorks structure systems. We now have the ability to design and position connection detailing intuitively on structural members without needing to create assemblies. Just like with weldment profiles, we can now create our own library of custom connections with configurations to suit our needs and position them within our models with precision and ease. We can create steel and timber connections and snap them into place, automatically cutting through appropriate bodies on demand. So how do we use this brand new feature? Well, let's take a look at how to add connection detailing to this seasonally appropriate timber frame staple. First, we need to make our connection elements. There are some sample profiles that come with SolidWorks 2022, but it's more than likely you'll be working with your own product or pre-manufactured parts. Here we have a simple sheet metal timber hanger, but any solid part can be used for connection elements. We recommend setting up a series of configurations for each size variation of parts to keep your models organized and accessible, just like this. Within our part, enable the Structure System tab. Selecting Define Connection Element allows us to specify faces and features for use when inserting and positioning the connection element. The placement type determines how many position references we can select. End connections only use one primary reference for centering around the end of a structural member, while the generic connection provides us with more flexibility when positioning. With three references to choose, we want to select those that will make the most sense when it comes to positioning. Here, our primary reference will be the plane that the connection fits against, and selecting the right plane as the secondary reference will allow us to keep the hanger centered about the structural elements. Our tertiary reference will be used to determine the vertical position of the connection. Mate types can be selected within the property manager for the references. Coincident mates are appropriate in this instance, but you can also choose from concentric and parallel mates, depending on your structural member's shape and connection type. The feature propagation box lets us select features that we want to have an influence on other bodies once we've inserted the connection. Use this when you've got holes in the connection element that will also cut into or through the structural members. For now, we'll save this part file to a local drive and we'll make sure to close the file once the connection element has been saved. We'll create another element, this time employing the Dimensions option. Under the Dimensions tab, we can create groups of named dimensions for configuring on insert. We'll rename our chosen dimensions for easy access and create appropriate groups for them. Dimension groups are a great feature if you need to manually adjust the size of a connection while viewing the structure, but we recommend using configurations to keep sizes consistent across models. With the connections created, we need SolidWorks to find them. Copy the part files into the Structure System Connection Elements folder. By default, this is located within your SolidWorks program files, SolidWorks, and then Data. Create new folders within here for standards or for each of the types of elements you're using. This will become your library for connection detailing. You can house as many elements as you want for both structural steel and timber. Now that's all the prep done. So now, how do we add connection elements to our structures? When it comes to inserting connection elements into your design, SolidWorks 2022 has made it exceptionally straightforward. Under the Structure Systems tab, select Insert Connection Element. A familiar weldment-like menu appears in the Property Manager. The Standard menu browses the top-level folders in the Connection Elements folder. The type is the file name, and the size is determined by the configurations within a connection element part. Selecting the Placement tab initiates the primary reference locator. These references relate to what we defined when creating the elements. Choose the appropriate faces for each reference, adjusting alignments and adding offsets as required. Note that when you are selecting references, the planes of structural members become visible for easy selection. The cut scope allows us to select which bodies we want to be affected by the propagating cuts. Connection elements sit in the feature manager tree as new features. These can then be edited to change or modify the detailing element and position. We'll add some more connection elements to our structure and pass our model through Visualize to see the full power of SolidWorks 2022. Check back regularly for more festive content and subscribe for more SolidWorks tips, tricks, and solutions. Wishing you happy holidays and a very Merry Christmas from all of us here at Solid Solutions.